Good evening, everyone. My name is Cindy Waters, and I'm the music director here at Pax Christi. Welcome. I would like to take a moment as we go back to congregational singing for the first time tonight to point out our new worship aids. Hopefully you received one out of the baskets in the back of church. Please remember to return these at the end of Mass so we can reuse them for our next three Masses. That would really help us out.
Please stand and join us in opening song, Glory and Praise to Our God.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Father.
Happy Father's Day, all you fathers, tomorrow. I'd like to admit my guilt. In case there happens to be a burglar among you all, I make this request. A burglar. I just locked my keys in my car. If there's a burglar in the congregation, would you see me after Mass? Let's pause for a moment and tell Christ we're sorry for our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh in splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory and praise to the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We pray.
Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those who set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea, when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment, and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it, and fastened the bar of its door, and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be still.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. They who sail the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, these saw the works of the Lord and His wonders in the abyss. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. His command raised up a storm wind, which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven, they sank to the depths. Their hearts melted away in their plight. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. They cried to the Lord in their distress. From their straits He rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and the billows of the sea were stilled. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is everlasting. They rejoiced that they were calm, and He brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for His kindness and His wondrous deeds to the children of man. Give thanks to the Lord, His love is
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us, once we have come to the conviction that the one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for Him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know Him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
A great prophet has risen among us. God has visited his people.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even the wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord. Being Father's Day, and mothers and fathers are like God to their children. The younger they are, they're not God anymore in teenage years, but the younger they are, I'd like to just look at a couple images of God and have you think, what's the image that you have of your father? And he helped you to image God the Father. I sort of think God the Father gets cheated. First of all, for years we were saying, don't say Father. You know, they would sometimes go, "Mother, Father," you know, in the readings. And, you know, we celebrate Advent and a time after Christmas all about Jesus Christ. Good, and rightly so. And then we get Christ again in Lent, his sufferings and death. And then 7 weeks after Easter, it's still resurrection of Jesus again. And then we pull out the stops one time for the Holy Spirit, Pentecost Sunday. Why isn't there a God the Father Day? Fathers, we fathers are prejudiced against. This really applies to father and mother, but as far as, I guess, we wound up calling God our Father because of the whole history of power, control, and force. That was God, the mystery of God. We had to keep the force, the power, and control it by offering sacrifice. And then the revelation came through Jesus Christ, "The Father has sent me." But I just find it interesting, there's no Father's. There's a Father's Day in our country, and I think a Father's Day and a Mother's Day in our country is really good, really good. Especially if they're still alive, or especially if you had a good father or a good mother. And I always felt like I had a good mother and a good father. And I really believe that the way I comprehend God has been influenced by my father. How about you? Well, just two things. One is, in that first reading of the book of Job, Job is trying to figure out God, whether it's God, Father, Son, or Holy Spirit. Here he is in that story, not like what happens in the boat at the gospel, which is history, but in this story, Job can't figure out he didn't do anything wrong. Why should he lose his wife? Why should his children be killed in an accident? Why should he lose his livestock? And why should he lose his health? And he did all four. And some people came in to try to explain God to Job. They said, well, you sinned. Therefore, God is punishing you for your sin, so admit your sin to God, and then everything will be fine. Job couldn't figure it out that he sinned. But Job wasn't a happy camper. He was a sad one. And he couldn't figure out how God could do this. And toward the end of the book and so forth, God sort of appears and says, Job, you know, I'm God, you're Job. Where were you when I made the seas and gave them their boundaries? That's the reading from Job in that first reading. Where were you? You know, where were you, Job? And Job finally says, I can't comprehend God. God is mystery. Maybe your father was that way. Or did you offer sacrifice to keep your father happy? Or was your father an unbelievable influence in your life, made in the image and likeness of God and acted like God? I think we all have different experiences. But Job sort of figured out the image of God was this mystery that I don't know. Well, then, the disciples, they were with Jesus in the boat. He was down a cushion or something, down a mushroom. I can't envision this because I can't envision a great big boat on the Sea of Galilee where Jesus is downstairs on pillows and the other guys are out there swamping the deck, you know, because it's going down. And they were upset. They were upset with Jesus because they were very fearful. They were going down and he's down there sleeping. And so they got and said, oh, what? Get up here, we need you. And then he gets up and I don't know what he did as far as he calmed the sea or the lake or he calmed the winds or the water stopped. And they were getting a new inkling of God, you know? Because when this happened, well, Jesus says, why are you afraid? You know, have faith in me. We're doing fine. It wasn't fine at all. They were going down. And after he did this, awe and wonder comes. They were filled with great awe and said to one another, who then is this whom even wind and sea obey? So our God is an active, powerful, saving God like Jesus. And our God sent Jesus, the Father sent Jesus, and the Holy Spirit has that Pentecost Sunday, or the Holy Spirit has come, but the Holy Spirit is going to penetrate the church until the rest of the time before the totality of the kingdom of God. And so we respect very much the Holy Spirit. Well, my point is, you dads out there have been probably great people if you had kids and tried to explain God, because at one time you were God. It applies on Mother's Day too, so we're not ruining mothers tonight. And it's unbelievably powerful how the image of a dad, you know, I remember we always grouped together, they camped out or made tree camps and ran around together, about eight of us, you know, these guys. And I remember we would get into arguments sometime. You know what? My dad can beat up your dad. And I meant it. He could beat up Mr. Rummel next door because he was a floozy. And my dad wasn't. In my head, my dad was wonderful. And I really think God the Father is wonderful, positive, because of my dad. I don't know. How about you? Was your father? If he wasn't, then I hope your mother was darn good. And if she too was terrible, I hope somebody loves you. Because we are influenced. The younger we are, the greater the influence. And the one who is in charge when we're really young sets a lot of the pace for our understanding of God. So I just think, congratulations, all you fathers who did what you did. And I now would like you fathers to stand up for a blessing, if you would. All fathers, please stand. Let us pray. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men, our fathers, that they may be strong and strengthened as Christian fathers. Lead the example of their faith and their love, and let it shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's give them a hand. Please stand for the creed. I believe in one God. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. With our faith nourished by the words of sacred scripture, let us voice some of our needs in prayer to the Lord. For the church throughout the world, that it may be united in prayer for the ongoing conversion of those who still do not know Christ, we pray to the Lord. For those who preach and teach the word of God in our world, that they may boldly proclaim the promise of salvation, we pray to the Lord. For lawmakers, may they work to reflect care and compassion for the poor and the vulnerable in our society, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for all creation and for all life, which comes from the Lord of the earth, the sky, and the sea, we pray to the Lord. For all fathers, that this Father's Day may encourage and strengthen them to be faithful in their calling to give themselves in love to their families, we pray to the Lord. For the sick, those who are dying, those who have died, may the peace of Christ live in the hearts of their families, and especially for the eternal joy of George Saretsky, for whom we pray this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, You give us all we need. As you answer these prayers, increase our gratitude and our faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation in praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, Christ humbled himself, was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Christ took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, all the clergy and laity. Remember also all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let's offer to one another a sign of peace.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
meet face to face. Our lives are in your hands. Our lives are in your hands. Our love for you will grow, O Lord. Your light in us will shine. Your light in us will shine.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
An announcement from Father Pat that beginning next Saturday, June 26th, we will return to having regularly scheduled confessions from 4 p.m. to 4:30 every Saturday. Please arrive by 4:20 so that the priest can begin preparing for Mass by 4:30. So those who have been asking, we do have confessions coming back. Another thing we have coming back is next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, the chairs in the, everything that's up here in the church will be moved downstairs. Masses will be held downstairs in one of the nice rooms that has the big window in it. You will be able to get in this door and get to the elevator by the time masses start, but we're having the floors scrubbed and high buffed in preparation for having our formal cloth blue chairs to come back hopefully by Friday. So hopefully next weekend we'll have the regular blue chairs back. The pews, of course, are going to take some time to get them refinished. But it's a sign back to normalcy. The other thing, the exciting news is, you know, God, in God's time, not ours, Father did hire a business manager, property manager last week, and it is Michael Whitney. He's a member of the Cathedral of Christ the King. He has operated his own business and knows both business and property. So we're very fortunate to have him come on the staff, and he started on Wednesday. So hopefully one Sunday soon you'll be able to meet him. Please stand.
Isn't it nice to have music with musicians? Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Join us for Stand By Me.
When the storms of life are raging, Lord, stand by me. When the current pulls me under, Lord, stand by me. When the rising waters toss me like a ship upon the sea, you who rule the wind and water, Lord, stand by me. Stand by me, stand by me. Lift me up from the restless sea. When I am lost, when love can't be found, when no one cares, Lord, stand by me. In the midst of persecution, Lord, when the tyrant's wheels his terror, and the armies wage their might, when the dark